was recently asked to give a presentation to my department. I wanted to talk about asphalt pavements, which is my main field of study, while at the same time appealing to a diverse audience. Thus, I came up with this topic on the similarity between asphalt pavements and humans. Both asphalt pavements and humans are complex systems. On the face of it, at first glance, they seem distinct, completely unassociated. With this presentation, I hope to convince you that the overlap is greater than the disjunction. What is an asphalt pavement? The official definition of a pavement is a layered system made of geomaterials that is designed and built to serve as a physical transportation infrastructure. Asphalt pavements are the most common pavement type. From top to bottom, they are composed of asphalt concrete, unbound base and subbase, subgrade, and deeper medium of soil mass or rock mass. Similar to pavements, humans are also layered. Here's an example for a human head. As can be seen, it is composed of several layers from surface inward. We have skin, superficial fat, superficial muscles, retaining ligaments, deep fat, outer bone membrane, and bone. Pavements commonly host a wide variety of pipes, cables, and tubes. These are needed for transferring electrical signals, such as power and communication. They are needed for transporting liquids, such as cold water, hot water, sewage. Some pipes are designed for transporting gases, phases, like cooking gas and steam. Recently, we have added fiber optic cables that transport light. Similar to pavements, humans contain a wide variety of pipes, cables, and tubes. The nervous system is a network of wires transferring electrical signals. Liquids are transported by our blood vessels and urine system. We can also transport gases, for example, in our respiratory system. We are able to transport light, at least the effects of light, via our eyes and skin. New pavements have a distinct smell. It is due to the release of aromatic hydrocarbons. This smell takes several days to fade away. Similarly, human babies have a distinct smell. The smell is due to a greasy coating that covered and protected their skin during pregnancy. This smell takes also several days to fade away. Young asphalt pavements have glossy black surfaces. The lane markings are vibrant and sharp. Similarly, young humans have good looks with glossy hair, vibrant skin, and sharp features. Pavement surfaces need the periodic sweeping and washing to remove dust and other surface contaminants. This is to promote overall safety and specifically better visibility of road markings and better wet skid resistance. Also, a clean road is pleasant to others. Similarly, humans wash periodically to remove surface contaminants and promote overall health and wellness. Also, a clean human is pleasant to others. Pavements continually work under pressure. The pressure is due to a combination of traffic loads and weather effects. Nonetheless, they are expected to deliver peak performance at all times and under all circumstances. Pavements are rarely given time to rest. Time for care and maintenance is always limited. Similarly, humans work under pressure for years, specifically time pressure and emotional pressure. Nonetheless, they are expected to deliver peak performance at all times and under all circumstances. Humans are rarely given time to rest. Time for care and maintenance is always limited. Here is a common damage in asphalt pavements called cracking. The human equivalent for this is a cut. Here is another common damage in asphalt pavements. It is called bleeding or flushing. This happens when the bitumen decides to leave the asphalt concrete, normally under hot temperature conditions. This is the human equivalent of this. This is sweating, also happening under hot temperature conditions. Another common damage for asphalt pavements is roughness, where the road loses its smoothness. And the human equivalent for this is kyphosis. Pavement surfaces are visually inspected to assess damage levels. Here you can see a surface inspection vehicle as an example. The results of these inspections are recorded, classified, and reported. Warning flags are raised if values exceed normal or expected ranges. Similarly, human surfaces are visually inspected to assess damage levels. The results are recorded, classified, and reported. Warning flags are raised if values exceed normal or expected ranges. Pavements are often tested with the FWD, the falling weight deflectometer. The device applies an impulse load that strikes the surface and triggers a brief mechanical response. The test targets deep structural behavior, and the recorded responses are important for assessing the integrity of the pavement system. Humans are often tested with a tiller reflex hammer. With the device, an impulse load is applied, striking the skin and triggering a brief reflex response. The tiller hammer targets the behavior of deep tendon reflexes, and the observed response is important in assessing the integrity of the nervous system. Pavement cracks are sealed to prevent water from entering the structure and subgrade. This prolongs service life. A human analogy to crack sealing is makeup. One common reason for wearing makeup is covering up imperfections like acne and scars. Another analogy for crack sealing is the application of sunscreen to prevent the UV radiation from attacking the skin. This prolongs service life. A common repair activity in asphalt pavements is resurfacing, where the top part of the old and aged asphalt concrete is milled and a new layer is paved over it. This gives the pavement a fresh look, cancels unevenness, and renews skid resistance. However, the old existing structure below remains. The human analogy for pavement resurfacing is cosmetic surgery, where the skin after the procedure looks fresh and smooth. However, the old existing below remain untouched. Another human analogy to milling the top part of an old and aged asphalt concrete is a haircut, where the split and dry ends are trimmed away. Asphalt pavements age. Over the years, they turn gray, become deformed, more brittle, and display signs of fatigue and scars from past damages and repair attempts. Humans age. Over the years, they turn gray, become deformed, more brittle, and display signs of fatigue and scars from past illnesses and repair attempts. When new strain is applied to an asphalt concrete, the resulting stress initially jumps to a high level and then subsides and drops over time. It can be said that the material's memory of the strain application event is fading. Similarly, when human learns new information, his recollection ability jumps to a high level and then subsides or drops over time. This is the classic forgetting curve of Hermann Ebbinghaus, a 19th century German psychologist that pioneered the experimental study of human memory. Asphalt concrete has an innate capacity to self-heal during rest period. Here is an example. We torture a small asphalt beam until it breaks. This takes 5 consecutive cycles. However, if we stop after 4 cycles before failure and allow rest time, the material heals and can endure 4 more cycles. This is similar to humans, where rest is needed in order to heal bones, and weekends and vacations are essential to cope with life's stresses. The asphalt road you can see here was badly constructed, leading to fast deterioration and poor performance. One can say that it has bad genes, which are known to increase the tendency for certain illnesses. On the other hand, having good genes decreases the tendency for certain illnesses and offers improved potential performance. There are many other similarities between asphalt pavements and humans. For example, material composition. Asphalt concrete is a mixture of aggregates, rock fragments, and bitumen, asphalt cement. If these are not compatible, poor bond is achieved, leading to a quick disintegration of the mix. In marriage relationship, if there exists a compatibility issue, poor bond is achieved between the pair, leading to a quick disintegration of the relationship. Recycling. Pavements are often milled, and the reclaimed material is utilized in new pavements. The human analogy is that of organ or blood donation. Perpetual pavements. Perpetual pavements is a concept for designing pavements that offer an infinite service life. In humans, this is similar to the search for immortality. Non-determinism. Engineers cannot examine an asphalt pavement and forecast when and where new damages will appear. Similarly, doctors cannot examine a human and forecast when and where new illnesses will appear. In terms of gender, and keep in mind this is a hypothetical exercise, I would argue that pavements are female. This is given the association with durability, resiliency, and long life. The comparison between asphalt pavements and humans is unusual. Nonetheless, I hope I was able to convince you that the overlap is greater than the disjunction.
I would like to acknowledge the contribution of ideas to this presentation from Karen Bannister and Anjali Jamie. Thank you for your attention.